आ रहा है।
कॉन्फ्रेंस हो रही है, सुन लेते हैं क्या कुछ कह रहे हैं।
एंड वी सक्सेसफुली डिफीटेड इट इन द लास्ट 2018 असेंबली पोल्स एंड वी फॉर्म द गवर्नमेंट। बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट फॉर 15 ईयर्स looted the state through manipulating huge tenders through e-tendering, arranging events, spending public money. You all know about the Vyapam case and all kinds of money making rackets went on. And then Nhani Trap also got exposed. There were BJP people involved in that also. Now all those people who were involved in these kind of activities and corruption, they knew that the screws were tightening, the noose was tightening around their neck. And Mr. Kamal Nath, as a chief minister, also started a very strong campaign against the land mafia, against the adulteration, against the mining mafia. He drafted a new mining policy for the sand and a transparent policy by which the mines were allotted through auction. All this was unpalatable to the BJP leadership, and from day one they started offering money to our Congress legislators because of the very close mandate which we had in 2018 assembly election. It is very unfortunate the wonderful state of Karnataka and the city of Bengaluru is becoming infamous for horse trading. It's very unfortunate. The Kannada history, culture has been of the highest traditions. But now the way the politics is being done by the BJP, it is very unfortunate. Huge sums are being distributed to buy MLAs. Anyway, Congress Party is a national party which believes in the ideology of Mahatma Gandhi and Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Baba Saheb Ambedkar, has always fought these forces. What is not important is whether we form a government or not, but what is more important is that the nation should go, the parliamentary democracy, the Indian nation and the national democracy should be in the right direction, in the right path. We should respect the mandate. Unfortunately, Mr. Narendra Modi and Amit Shah don't think so. Even in BJP, the old traditional thought of Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee's kind of leadership is no more there. The leadership which controls the BJP now is that of people have joined hands to do all kinds of unscrupulous things, which has led to a stage in India where the banks are collapsing, NPA is growing, unemployment is growing, and we have a coronavirus threat which is as bad as the Spanish flu in the 1918. The government is not worried about that. The government is busy toppling duly elected governments. That is BJP. We had successfully thwarted the plans for destabilizing the government. But we were let down by Mr. Jyotiraj Scindia, who had a very successful career in the Congress Party, Member of Parliament, twice Member of the Cabinet, Member of the Working Committee, General Secretary of the Congress Party, Deputy Leader in the Parliament. We never expected that Mr. Jyotiraj Scindia will ditch us and join hands with the BJP, the very party which defeated him in the last Lok Sabha election. He goes and joins. Look at the moral of the BJP, and unfortunately Mr. Jyotiraj Scindia, that he had to join hands with those people whom he was opposing outright in his speeches in the parliament and outside the parliament. Even 1 week before he decided to part from the Congress Party, he tweeted that the farmers' loans are being waived, and he congratulated the government. And 1 week later he says that nothing is happening. All these MLAs who have come in, who has paid for their charter flights? BJP. Who accompanies them? The BJP leaders. Who pays their hotel bills? BJP. And they say it is an internal matter of the Congress Party. Well, as a member of the Raj Sabha and the Congress candidate in the elections to be held on 26th of March, it is my right to approach my voters. And this is exactly what I wanted to do. I was told they are staying in a hotel which is a public place. And a public place is where anyone can go and meet anyone who wants to meet. Why was I stopped by the police? If the guests of the Ramada Hotel didn't want to meet me, they could have stayed in their room. I wouldn't have broke open their door to meet them. But why should the Karnataka police stop me? This is my objection. What right, under what law, was I stopped to get into the hotel? Why was I stopped? Why was I lifted? Why did the Karnataka police misbehave with me? This is my objection.
Violation of fundamental right of movement.
Mr. Ugurappa is, of course, the great constitutional expert. He is telling me that this is a violation of fundamental right. It's absolutely yes. So my point is simple. That I wanted the state government and the police to provide access to the hotel where I can have one-to-one meeting with the MLAs.
As a candidate.
As a candidate of the Congress party contesting in this Rajya Sabha election. Whom I want to meet? I don't want to meet the BJP MLAs. I don't want to do horse trading. I want to meet my own duly elected Congress MLAs who have won on the Congress ticket. Why should I be stopped? Now, when we met the DDP, he, as rightly Shiv Kumar Hasji has pointed out, I was very surprised. There's a young MLA called Manoj Chaudhary from Devas. His father had come to meet his son and he complained to the DGP. And I was shocked to see the letter which is supposedly written by his son, Manoj Chaudhary. Narayan Chaudhary was my Jilla Parishad president and he contested as a Congress candidate, the old congressman. That he doesn't want to meet the father. If this is the condition of the stranglehold of the people who are controlling the premises of this hotel, how can I expect any kind of response from my MLAs? I filed in the Karnataka High Court with a plea that I may be asked, I may have an access to the MLAs, which is under discussions. 4:30 onwards is going to be taken up. It's been moved already. So I will await that. At the same time, Supreme Court is also looking at these issues. I'm sure the Supreme Court and the High Court will protect my fundamental right to have an access to a public place and also meet the Congress MLAs in a free environment, not a controlled environment. I have decided that I will await the decision of the Supreme Court and the High Court and will then take a view of staging a dharna. As it stands today, I have decided to be on fast and shall take a call on that after I see the Supreme Court and the High Court decision. Through you, I would like to appeal to my MLAs in Ramana Hotel. Main unse prarthna karta hu ki ye sab log jo hai कांग्रेस के चुनाव चिन्ह पर चुनाव जीतकर आए हैं। कांग्रेस के हजारों कार्यकर्ताओं ने, लाखों कार्यकर्ताओं ने मेहनत करके उनको इस लायक बनाया, वे विधायक बने, विधानसभा में पहुंचे, सरकार कांग्रेस की बनी और आज जिस तरह का व्यवहार वो कर रहे हैं, मेरी उनसे हाथ जोड़कर अपील है कि वे ऐसा ना करें। उनके कोई दिक्कत परेशानियां हैं तो हम लोग दूर करेंगे और मैंने कही भी है, अनेक एमएलए ऐसे हैं जो मेरे कैबिनेट के मेंबर थे, मेरे पारिवारिक रिश्ते उनसे, लेकिन उनके परिवार के लोगों से भी नहीं मिलने दे रहे हैं। इस तरह का कंट्रोल कर्नाटक की पुलिस ने किया हुआ है, मैं इसकी निंदा करता हूं। विधायकों की खरीद फरोख्त के मैं हमेशा खिलाफ रहा हूं और मैं इसमें विश्वास नहीं करता और मैं इसकी घोर निंदा करता हूं। इसका पूरा का पूरा जो ऑपरेशन हुआ है वो अमित शाह और नरेंद्र मोदी के डायरेक्शन में हुआ है और
I don't think you think of permission, you have moved the Kanaka idol.
Yes.
Your prayer is to give them permission, give you permission to meet them.
Yes.
तो बीजेपी तो सीधी तस्वीरें इस वक्त आपको दिखा रहे थे जहां पर मध्य प्रदेश के पूर्व मुख्यमंत्री दिग्विजय सिंह प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस कर रहे थे और प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में तमाम आरोप लगाते हुए भारतीय जनता पार्टी पर कि किस तरह से विधायकों को खरीद पर हॉर्स ट्रेडिंग की कोशिश की जा रही है, किस तरह से उनको खरीदा जा रहा है और किस तरह से बंधक बना के रखा गया है। वहीं जब वो बेंगलुरु पहुंचते हैं तो बेंगलुरु में किस तरह से उनको मिलने नहीं दिया जाता है, मिलना तो बहुत दूर की बात है, उनको बेंगलुरु पुलिस डिटेंशन में ले लेती है। वो ये कहते हैं कि जब तक हम अपने साथियों से नहीं मिल लेते हैं तब तक हम यहीं होटल के बाहर, रमादा होटल के बाहर धरना देंगे और इसी बीच उनको बेंगलुरु पुलिस डिटेंशन पे ले लेती है। तो प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस दिखा रहे थे दिग्विजय सिंह की कि क्या कुछ तमाम गंभीर आरोप लगाए हैं और इस वक्त डिबेट में हमें SP त्रिपाठी चैनल हेड उन्होंने भी ज्वाइन